What's going on, everybody? This is Phil with Millennial Money Gains, and welcome back to a brand new video. In this video, we are going to go over our dividend portfolio for the past week, as we do every single week. We're going to look at what kind of moves I made for the week, and this one's going to be a pretty short video. There's not much to go over. I just really have mainly one thing to go over with you guys. So if you guys are hyped for this video, please make sure you smash that like button. And if you like these weekly updates on the dividend portfolio, make sure you subscribe to the channel, because we post here at least once per week going over the dividend portfolio. Also, we will be doing in our next video a dividend income update on what we received for the month of November. So make sure you stay tuned for that. Make sure you subscribe for that, because we did hit our biggest month ever at this point in dividends. But let's hop into today's video. So in the last day on Friday, it was a shorter day in the market. It was a shorter week in the market. I was down $50. Market was pretty flat. Past week, Thanksgiving week. Hope you all had a wonderful Thanksgiving, by the way. We were up about almost 1%, which is $255. So not too bad there for a shorter week. So the portfolio is currently sitting at $26,683.76. And the one thing that I did want to go over is that we bought a call and sold a call on VUZI. Ticker symbol is VUZI. So if you guys, I'm not going to go too far into the company. I'm really just going to show you what I did with these plays here. So I did buy a call and I did sell a call. So this one is I sold a $5 call on VUZI. VUZI is sitting at around $4.46 at the time I'm making this video. So I did sell a $5 call on VUZI, which I did make $17 on. Now the date I sold this was on 11/21, which was 6 days ago at the time I'm recording this video. And we are up about 23.5%, and that's if I bought it right now. If I bought it back, we'd be up about 23.5%, which is only $4. I did only make $17 on the call, and it is going to expire on December 16th. So let me just tell you my thinking around this as we go into the call that I bought. So I did only have to spend, as you can see here, I spent on the call that I did buy. I spent $177 and I bought a call that is in the money, so I bought a $3 call. It did cost me $177. It's currently sitting at $175 right now, so I'm down about $2 on the play, which is less than 1%, or just over 1% rather. This is expiring on July 21st, 2023. So the only way that this will be a failed option for me is if it expires worthless. So if it expires under $3 for me, then I will lose a decent amount of money on this call that I bought. But remember, each and every single month I will be selling covered calls to go against this. So let's just say I can make about $17 a month, and we do this for a total of 8 months. That would be $136 I am making from this one call that I bought for $177. So I'll pretty much be making 100% on my money, and that's not including the value of the call. So if VUZI does go above $5, then the call that I sold, if it does that before December 16th, the call that I sold will expire, and I will get assigned the shares, but I have this call. So I would just lose this call, and this call would expire at whatever price it is. But if it's at $5, I will also make money on the play. So I'm making money, hopefully, on both sides. As long as VUZI doesn't drop in price too much, I will be making money. So that's my kind of thought process there, just to increase my monthly income a little bit. And besides that, for the dividend portfolio, I did buy one more share of SCHD, of course. So that I did buy on Tuesday. So now SCHD, I'm currently sitting at 13.58 shares. SCHD is currently sitting at $78.43 at the time I'm making this video. and I have over $1,000 in equity for SCHD. My total return is almost 9%, which is very good there, which almost $90 rather. It's about 4% of my portfolio. Remember, like I said, I do want to bring this up to about 10% or so. And my current average cost is $71.98. So for those of you who don't know, I do invest $75 into SCHD every single week. Originally, it was buying me more than one share per week, but since the price has risen a little bit, it has only been buying me less than a full share. So I'd rather the price come down, in all honesty, because I'd rather get more for my $75. But for now, they're doing okay. We did like it when it was at $67 or so. That really did decrease my average cost. But we're going to keep doing this. SCHD is a great investment. Over the past year, it is up about 0.84% compared to the market, which is down about 17%. So it's pretty good there. In the past 5 years, it is up about 59%. Now let's just see what the S&P 500 is returning in the past 5 years, just to compare this a little bit. I'm curious to see if SCHD outpaced the S&P 500. So the S&P 500 returned about 54.4%. So SCHD is outpacing the S&P 500. So pretty good there. That is why, one of the main reasons I chose SCHD as my weekly investment. But now let's hop over to the spreadsheet. So the cost basis did reach over $28,000, which is pretty awesome to see. My dividend yield, I'm not exactly sure why this is saying it's only 1.33% right now. My yield on cost is 1.24%. So something's wrong there, which I will figure out what that is. But my annual income, something is not getting calculated here because my annual income is not $349. So we're going to take a look here and see exactly what happened. Looks like everything is pretty normal, so maybe this just hasn't really finished loading. But what I wanted to show you guys as that decides to do something. So right now in the month of November, we have made $40 in covered call income, which is lower than the average. We still do have this last week that we'll be contributing to it. So hopefully we can get to at least that $50 mark. We'll see. But here it is, my new little thing. I have to create a chart for this. I just didn't have it at the time, but I will be doing that. I did buy Voozy on November 21st. I bought a $177 call, and I sold a $17 call. So this one expires December 16th, and this one expires July 21st in 2023. So that is pretty much all I wanted to show you guys. If you guys did enjoy this video, please make sure you smash that like button. I really do appreciate it. Also, if you want to join the family, hit that subscribe button. We post here at least once per week. And you guys will get to see updated information on my portfolio. Remember, next week, we are going to be going over the dividend income that I received for the month of November, which has been the highest month yet. So very happy about that. But I will see you guys in the next video, and I appreciate you all for watching. Peace!